Matt, you know this to be true, but it seems like when we talk late season food sources, everybody immediately thinks standing corn, standing soybeans.
It's almost like gospel to a deer
hunter.
You
have to, even if you're down south, and it's one of the biggest mysteries that I've never been able to figure out.
That's right.
And I think it goes with a lot of outdoor television hunts in the Midwest, but a lot of guys are watching and they're not in the Midwest.
They try and apply regional techniques that make sense in one location, but doesn't completely transfer and make sense in that region, given their stress periods, given their temperatures.
Right.
We're here, we're in southern Missouri. At what time frame?
And it's early January here, and we just got out of a couple of days of in the teens. The
yes.
temperatures were 17, wind chills were single digits, and we're standing in what we planted was a perennial clover field. It's got
yep.
a great mix of chicory and different types of perennial clover. And I think this is something that most guys in the South and a lot of guys in the Midwest and Mid-Atlantic can apply and be much more successful than
Absolutely.
Having standing grain. And that is having this food source, because this could provide forage from January through December.
Absolutely. I mean, when you compare that directly side by side to planting things such as soybeans or corn, mm-hmm. you're looking at many of the months out of the year where, let's take corn for example first. You're planting that in April, May in a lot of regions, but really it's not good quality food that deer are hitting until that corn kernel actually matures out.
So that could be October,
correct.
November, December, and then you have to play the game. Is it enough acreage to
provide
a food source during the winter months and early spring? And a lot of times it's not for many guys.
And then on the flip side, from a soybean standpoint, you're looking at late April, May. Sure, that provides forage throughout the growing season. But let's be honest, most food plot situations aren't large enough to where you're going to plant a soybean and it's going to have pods that make it all the way through to the late season anyhow. That's
yeah.
really common and kind of that frustrating point that many hunters deal with when planting soybeans. But the whole time that the corn was waiting to grow to produce something, or the soybeans were getting over-browsed,
this is looking amazing.
This is providing forage.
Yes. So this is taking a look at perennial clover plots during one of the worst times of the year.
Yep.
During this late winter, or I guess late season, early winter, when temperatures are really cold. And if you look around, you can see that this is still green, still providing forage.
Yep.
It's being hit hard because in this big chunk of timber, this is one of the only food sources. But the great thing about this is, this week, later on, we're going to get up into the 50s. We get
mm-hmm.
a couple days in a row of 50 degrees. This is going to perk up and going to continue providing great forage.
Absolutely. And the other benefit is, you know, when we're talking about stress periods from a wildlife standpoint, whether you're talking deer or turkeys, food source in late winter is very limited. And going into spring, that transition for both of those species, whether you're talking antler production or you're talking lactation for does, or that last trimester for producing fawns, or turkeys are getting ready to be reproducing themselves, this right here is green way before any of the grain crops are being planted. So it's just another window that this is really applicable and makes a lot of sense from a food standpoint. If you're a recreational landowner trying to have food plots, don't overlook perennial-based clover systems like this.
Especially, I mean, in all parts of the country, but especially in the South and the Midwest,
Absolutely.
Mid-Atlantic. I feel like clover should be almost the foundation of your food plot system.
Yep.
Because it can withstand so much more than annual blends.
We're talking in those regions, 10, 11, sometimes on different growing seasons, you know, in the year, we're talking a 12-month crop.
Yeah.
That's production, and that's honestly
not,
making the most
doesn't
use.
Doesn't have to be planted every
yeah.
single year.
And you're making the most use out of the acres that you have to produce the most amount of food for what you're trying to achieve. I love clover.
Don't
I know
sleep.
You love clover.
Don't sleep on perennial clover food plots.
That's right.